Now we have a NAFTA verification. This is an audit program where customs says, okay, so you submitted the certificate of origin, CBP 1434. Substantiate, how did you do your calculations? Provide us documentation, provide us work records, provide us the electricity bills, provide us stuff, right? It can be initiated through the documentation request, such as through the CBP form 28 inquiry. It can also be done through in-person visits of customs official on site. So they go out to Mexico and they visit the place. Is the factory really out there? Does it exist? So, and if it does exist, what is the production process? Is it consistent with the stuff that have been declared at the time of making the claim, for the duty preferential treatment? All right. So a NAFTA verification may not be conducted in which one of the following circumstances? All right. So I think this is not to understate the obvious, right? So when you cannot conduct the origin, customs wishes to verify NAFTA claim by means of questionnaire. As I mentioned, it is a way to do that. The importer made a post-liquidation claim. Post-liquidation, post-importation, I think that's what they're talking about. Recall that the time limit for filing is 1 year. So it is after the date of importation. So it is possible that liquidation takes place before 1520D time limit runs out. The importer has not been able to provide CBP form 434 to customs. So notice the certificate of origin or CBP form 434 is a key element for making the claim. If you do not have that certificate of origin on file, you were not in a position to make a claim to begin with, meaning that there is nothing to verify in the first place. So this is kind of like saying, well, since there is nothing to verify, there is no purpose of the verification. So this correct answer choice, because there is nothing to verify here. There is no document based upon which this verification can be made. So the C is the correct answer choice on this one. The other one, the D, customs wishes to conduct NAFTA verification by physical visit, that's fine. And E, customs wishes to verify status of claim by conducting the visit to the producer of goods, right? So notice Canada or Mexico, not the United States, because why? Because the certificate must be signed by whom? By the exporter. It's one of the few, if not the only free trade agreement, which requires exporter, which mandates that exporter signs the certificate of origin. All right, so we'll go to the laundry list, means of verification, letter, questionnaire, visit to premises. Okay, so kind of piggying back on that one, under NAFTA, customs may initiate verification in order to determine whether a good qualifies as an originating good for purposes of preferential tariff treatment, such as such verification cannot be conducted by which of the following means. Of course, A stands out, a written questionnaire sent to U.S. manufacturer. So remember what I said about U.S. manufacturer? No, it must be Canada or Mexico. Questionnaire sent to the producer or exporter of Canada or Mexico, because the burden is on the exporter to prove that the product qualifies, not on the importer, right? Again, this is one of the extricacies of the NAFTA, that the burden lies with the exporter. So here, when you have the burden on the U.S. manufacturer or producer, no. This is the United States, so the exporting country here would be either Mexico or Canada under NAFTA. So it must be the Mexican or the Canadian, not the United States manufacturer, making incorrect, a correct, because verification cannot be sent to someone who has no burden of coming with the production of the requested documents. Verification of the request information from a Canadian or Mexican exporter, on the other hand, fits the bill. So Canadian or Mexican, we are fine. Visit to Canadian or Mexican exporter is also fine, right? A written questionnaire sent to the exporter or producer, again, focus on the exporter or producer and any method which results in information. So pretty much anything goes as long as you have Canadian or Mexican side, but not the United States side involved. So A is a correct answer choice for this one.